You might have heard the phrase that we know more about space than we know about the oceans of Earth. This is true because billions of dollars of both government and private money goes into space research and exploration. We can't deny we are also fascinated with space. Every year, there is a new invention or a discovery that rekindles interest in space for people from all over the world. James Webb Space Telescope is one of those inventions. It has been under development for many years now, but with its completion, it has opened the doors for a lot of new discoveries. So without further ado, let's know more about this amazing breakthrough that is going to take space exploration to new horizons. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, is a space telescope and an international collaboration among NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency. The telescope is named after James E. Webb, who was the administrator of NASA from 1961 to 1968 and played an integral role in the Apollo program. It is intended to succeed the Hubble Space Telescope as NASA's flagship mission with astrophysics. JWST was launched December 25, 2021 on Ariane flight VA-256. It is designed to provide improved infrared resolution and sensitivity over Hubble, viewing objects up to 100 times fainter, and will enable a broad range of investigations across the fields of astronomy and cosmology, including observations of some of the oldest, most distant events and objects in the universe, such as the first stars and formation of the first galaxies, and allowing detailed atmospheric characterization of potentially habitable exoplanets. The Ariane 5 launch vehicle provides thrust for roughly 26 minutes after liftoff from French Guiana. The first stage is fire, consumes their fuel, cut off, and separate. Finally, the upper stage fires, giving Webb its final push up and away from Earth's gravity and onto a trajectory toward its L2 orbit. The upper stage engine completes its burn, cuts off, and separates. Webb is released from the Ariane 5 and is flying on its own in a fully stowed state. Upper stage separation. Moments after upper, second stage engine cutoff, Webb is released from the Ariane 5 and is flying on its own in a fully stowed state. Solar array. After shedding its fairing and booster rocket, the first two deployments are automatic, meaning they happen without the ground giving commands. Once the solar panel is deployed, the telescope will go off of battery power and start generating its own power. Mid-course correction burn 1A. This burn fine-tunes Webb's trajectory after launch. The duration of the burn will depend on Ariane 5 launcher performance. The James Webb Space Telescope is launched on a direct path to an orbit around the second Sun-Earth Lagrange point, L2, but it needs to make its own mid-course thrust correction maneuvers to get there. This is by design, because if Webb gets too much thrust from the Ariane rocket, it can't turn around to thrust back toward Earth, because that would directly expose its telescope optics and structure to the Sun, overheating them and aborting the science mission before it can even begin. Therefore, Webb gets an intentional slight underburn from the Ariane and uses its own thrusters and onboard propellant to make up the difference. There will be three mid-course correction MCC maneuvers: MCC-1A, MCC-1B, and MCC-2. The first burn, MCC-1A, is the most important and the only other time-critical operation aside from solar array deployment during Webb's commissioning period. Gimbaled Antenna Assembly. The Gimbaled Antenna Assembly, GAA, holds Webb's high-rate antenna. It is rotated to its parked position pointed back to the Earth. This is an automatic deployment as well as the solar panel which preceded it. All other deployments will be controlled by commands from the ground. The second, MCC-1B, is a shorter burn, performed before the sunshield deployment is scheduled to start. The final maneuver, MCC-2, performed 29 days after launch, is designed to insert Webb into the optimum orbit around L2. Forward sunshield pallet, the forward unitized pallet structure, UPS. The UPS supports and carries the 5 folded sunshield membranes. Prior to this, the spacecraft is maneuvered to provide warmer temperatures on the forward UPS, and various heaters are activated to warm key deployment components. Key release devices are activated. This step represents the start of the sunshield deployment phase and the start of all major deployments. The aft unitized pallet structure, UPS. The UPS supports and carries the five folded sunshield membranes. Prior to this, the spacecraft will have been maneuvered to provide warmer temperatures on the forward UPS, and various heaters have been activated to warm key deployment components. Deployable Tower Assembly, DTA. The Deployable Tower Assembly, DTA, is deployed. The tower extends 1.22 meters. This movement and distance provides needed separation between the spacecraft and telescope to allow for better thermal isolation and to allow room for the sunshield membranes to unfold. Aft momentum flap. The aft momentum flap is used to help offset some of the solar pressure that impinges on the large sunshield. Use of the momentum flap helps to minimize fuel usage during the mission. After releasing hold-down devices, a spring drives the rotation of the aft flap to its final position. Sunshield covers release. This operation releases and rolls up the protective membrane cover. The sunshield release cover has been protecting the membranes during ground and launch activities. Release devices are electrically activated to release the covers. Sunshield port mid-boom. The port plus J2 mid-boom deployment steps include the completion of the sunshield cover roll-up. This operation is a motor-driven deployment. Sunshield starboard mid-boom. The starboard minus J2 mid-boom deployment steps include the completion of the sunshield cover roll-up. This operation is a motor-driven deployment. Sunshield layer tensioning ongoing. This operation is a multi-step two-day activity, which completes the final membrane releases, as well as tensioning the five layers of the sunshield. After initial sunshield deployments of the forward and aft UPS, which carry the fully folded sunshield, followed by the port and starboard mid-booms, which support and initially unfold all five layers of the sunshield together, each layer is successively tensioned. Secondary mirror deployment. The deployment team begins planning and operations for the deployment of the secondary mirror support structure, SMSS, from its stowed launch position into its operational position. Webb's secondary mirror is at the end of this structure. As it is deployed, its long booms will swing the secondary mirror out in front of the primary mirror. The secondary mirror plays an important role in reflecting the light from the primary mirror to where the instruments sit, behind the primary mirror. Aft deployed instrument radiator. This activity releases the last of four launch locks that hold the aft deployed instrument radiator, ADIR, in its launch configuration. Releasing the last device allows springs to drive the ADIR into its final deployed position. The first three launch locks were released just after launch to prevent any unwanted strain in the system as the ADIR and telescope cools. Port primary mirror wing begins. The deployment team begins planning and operations for the deployment of the left port plus V2 primary mirror wing from its stowed launch position into its operational position. This operation deploys and latches the plus V2 wing of the primary mirror. Each wing holds three of the 18 mirror segments. This is a motor-driven deployment. Starboard primary mirror wing complete. The starboard primary mirror wing is fully deployed and latched. The right starboard minus V2 wing of the primary mirror is fully deployed and latched. Webb is fully deployed. The largest, most complex telescope ever launched into space is fully deployed. Webb will be the premier observatory of the next decade, serving thousands of astronomers worldwide. It will study every phase in the history of our universe, ranging from the first luminous glows after the Big Bang to the formation of solar systems capable of supporting life on planets like Earth to the evolution of our own solar system. Webb will continue to travel to the second Lagrange point, L2, for another 2 weeks, at which point it will enter a large orbit around the L2 point. The following 5 months will be used to cool the telescope to operating temperature, fine-tune the mirror alignment, and calibrate the instruments. Individual mirror segment movements. The primary mirror wings are now fully deployed and latched into place, but the individual mirror segments remain in their launch configuration. This operation is a multi-day, multi-step activity to activate and move each of the 18 primary mirror segments and the secondary mirror from their stowed launch configuration to a deployed position ready for alignment. The 18 primary mirror segments and secondary mirror are adjustable via six actuators that are attached to the back of each mirror. The primary mirror segments also have an additional actuator at its center that adjusts its curvature. The telescope's tertiary mirror remains stationary. The primary and secondary mirror segments will move a total of 12.5 millimeters in small increments over the course of approximately 10 days to complete each segment's deployment. After all individual mirror segment deployments are completed, the detailed optical mirror alignment process begins, which is about a 3-month process. In parallel, as temperatures cool enough, instrument teams will turn on their instruments and begin each instrument's commissioning process. L2 insertion burn. Mid-course correction burn MCC2 begins L2 insertion. A series of activities to plan and execute MCC2, the insertion burn for Webb's L2 orbit. MCC2 corrects any residual trajectory errors and adjusts the final L2 orbit. The James Webb Space Telescope is launched on a direct path to an orbit around the second Sun-Earth Lagrange point, L2, but it needs to make its own mid-course thrust correction maneuvers to get there. Webb is orbiting L2. Orbit insertion complete. Webb is orbiting L2 in a halo orbit. Telescope deployment is complete. Ongoing cooldown and instrument turn-on continue. The telescope and scientific instruments started to cool rapidly in the shade of the sunshield once it was deployed, but it will take several weeks for them to cool all the way down and reach stable temperatures. This cooldown will be carefully controlled with strategically placed electric heater strips. The remaining 5 months of commissioning will be all about aligning the optics and calibrating the scientific instruments. So there you have it, a complete and detailed video about the James Webb Space Telescope. We are sure you got to learn a lot of new things about the breakthrough invention. We hope you liked the video. For more videos like this one, subscribe to our channel and enable notifications by clicking on the bell icon.